Welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now you would have just heard my recent video talking about some of the specialist teams that operate inside the JCF. One of them was CTOC. Remember I did that video where I showed you the picture and I was saying these officers are rarely seen and it's really only 87 to them. And if you ever see one, they're probably the last people you're going to see. Well, here is a perfect example. But before I go into that, I just want to send a special Patreon birthday shout out to Lacey. And listen, you already sent me the picture of him, right? I know you get your hand shell and your toe shell and everything done. So just have a great day, right? Take care of yourself, live long and prosper, alright? So people, let's move into this operation. A stunning operation, if I may say so myself. I'm going to give you the background of the individuals involved, especially the main 87. And I'm also going to show you some pictures. Right, because when I tell you this operation is well planned out, the man named Carrot gone a firing. Right now, CTOC can move like, say, a Hollywood show them depend. Don't worry yourself, people. Sit back, enjoy, go and drink a cup of coffee. This one is sure to be interesting. Now, check this out. The main star of this Netflix show, okay, I don't know Jamaica's a Netflix series, is an 87 by the name of Ashado McFarlane. Now, in the news, you would see that he's referred to as Boise, as his nickname. Now, initially, I was getting a lot of messages telling me, Serpy, me, I say, Klansman, just get killed. And I was like, Klansman, where people are getting this information? All of a sudden, everybody done expert on Klansman. This individual is not a member of the Klansman gang. If he was, I would have pulled this file from the database in 3.26 milliseconds. Right, he's not a member of the Klansman gang. That's the first thing. He's not even a YouTube base, a Spanish town. Right, his real stomping ground or his main stomping ground was Mansfield Heights in Ochi. But after him get hot, you know, him start to move up and down, him the town, him the all about the place. Right, so let's look at this individual. Now, as me say, in the papers, them say his street name is Boise. However, most people who know him as Hardball. Look at your screen right now, because this picture might confuse you. This is Hardball in his what I would call his natural state, with his natural complexion. But when 87s get hot and they want to disguise their identity, one of the easiest and effective methods is to turn to the bleaching cream, right? So when I show you the picture of what he looks like right before he lost his life, you're going to see a complete different individual. But this is just an example of how easy it is for them to stay ahead of the security forces, right? But as me say, CTOC did a very good job catching up with him. So he not only changed his image or his appearance, right, but he started to tell everybody, say, Adus Boise name. That was the name he focused on, right? Because the name Hardball, once them hear that, people from Senton side hear that, people from Ochi side hear that, them know who them are dealing with, right? So I'm going to show you a picture right now. I'm going to show you how him look from when he was dark to when he went light. Then I'm going to show you the pictures of the operation, because when I tell you CTOC did a very good job on this one, I really mean it. So check out this photo on your screen right now, people. Same man, right, on the left and on the right. However, if you were looking for him and you did not have solid intelligence, you'd have walked right past the man on the right, right? Because it's almost impossible if you're just a casual observer to realize, eh, I just see a man name. Now you see why North 87 love the cream. Now you see why 87 are war with them kerosene over the cream. The 87 them now they fought them cream, because this is one of the best ways they use to sidestep the security forces. But before I go into the operation and how CTOC actually take him out and even show you some pictures in the build up, I want to give you a brief rundown on who this individual was. Right, the Ashado McFarlane character, aka Hardball, aka Boise. This youth was responsible. So far, 2020 alone, he was wanted for 9 killings, right, and he was a person of interest for 2. Right now, on Greener's website, them say 8, right, the title say wanted for 8 murders, right, but them list 9. And if you notice, most of them are either around Lindsay St. Catherine, right, or Mansfield Heights in Ochi Rios. So this youth was effectively a contract killer that had his own local team and him in Gomash Works, but other people would recruit him for go do certain things, including other gangs, right? So Klansman himself will tell you, go deal with this, see some money, and I'm gonna do it. But he's not under Klansman, so he doesn't really answer to Tesha or Blackman or Richie and nobody like that, right? He just take his money, do what he do, and go about his business. If you notice on the Gleaner website, the thing that stand out to me is that every single person we wanted for, every single body, right, that he's a person of interest for, happened in 2020. The first one, right, January 8, 2020, Rashaan Mahado, right, at Mansfield Heights, Ocherius. And the most recent one, right, is the murder of Steve Brown and Ronaldo Williams on the September 21st, 2020. This is extraordinary. This youth has had a very, very busy year. Hardball, he come like a 2020 and decided to step up his work ethic, right? His 87 work ethic went through the roof in 2020. So imagine what like one in 2019, 2018. People of Jamaica don't understand. There are people out there like this. One man, right, have 8-9 murders they wanted for. Two were my person of interest. And they walk up and down. And if CTAC never take him out, it'll probably be somebody else tomorrow and the week after that. This is extraordinary. But let's look at the operation itself. I wanted to look at your screen because I'm going to show you a picture. What me tell you is CTAC gone Hollywood. Check this out. Some of you may have seen the picture, right, of somebody dressed exactly like this with a little piece of hat in one bush. Yes, it's him. But that is the after. What you're looking at is the before. And you can go on the website politicwest.com and you can see what him look like after CTAC mash him up. Yes, this picture was taken by the team. He was under surveillance. So when I did the recent video and I told the people of Jamaica that there are specialist police teams in Jamaica, right? Exceptional officers, well trained, well skilled, all we need is more of them. And then see an example. I love when it play out like this. I love when, because it's one thing for me just say it. But when you see it come out, now you know, wagwan. We just need more of them. The days when time 87 do what them feel like, and then you go for them, lock them up, then go to court, nobody no come testify, them let go, and then back in the streets we carry on them foolishness. It look like those days are coming to an end. See, the team had visuals upon them right through the day. They were being tracked, they were being followed. Them could have run in upon them much earlier. But as you can see in this picture, they were in a very public space, right? So them never want to challenge them. Someone like writers, so they don't know 87 stay already. Wild shot could have catch civilians and all them thing there, right? So them allow them to do what they do. They must keep eyes on them. Excellent work. Now we are talking about policing. Because before, the little jumpy style of policing with Jamaica used to, as soon as them spot the 87, they might run in, shut a fire, 5-5-6 a fly one way, 9 a fire the next way, shut a fly the next way, all kind of people get mashed up. CTAC allowed them to move around, go buy all them food and walk up and down field. See me nice slippers? You know, see me like saying they on the beach, they at watch. Right, like him think of some vacation, him dip man like a plane, him a come off and them slippers. They not even bother him. Just keep eyes on him. Just keep him in your sight. We're talking about modern policing. The JCF is moving in the 21st century, right? They're stepping up their game. So, after them come together now, do what them a do, right? Jump in a car with them shotty, go and tell them, seriously, them a go mash ups again. Guess who them run into? Guess who was trailing them the whole time? CTAC. So now, the police them, corner them, right? Because they don't know it already, right? If 87 get backed up against the wall, especially these kind of 87s, somebody who is as wanted as Hardball, right, you already know them are the unlikely to handle themselves, right? So, after them get cornered, then decide say, them not go like that. One of them had a 12 gauge, right, I'm going to put it on the screen as well, decides they're going to challenge the police. From what I'm hearing is three of them being out of the car, two get mashed up, one get away. Again, you can go on politicswatch.com. You can see the pictures of both men. One of them, CTAC, I don't know what kind of gun in our fire, but then literally shut out the man close off him. People, I'm not exaggerating. Whoever, listen, I don't know who that officer was or officers, But them literally shut off the man close half time. I've never seen this before. What kind of gun that? The stripper 9000. You don't have to see the picture for yourself, people. Right, and I'm just giving you some fear warning. Right, if you know so on the stomach not too strong, or when you just have on a breakfast in the early morning, just give it a little time, nobody gotta look on the picture them yet. Right. But there is the weapon on your screen, right? That is a Remy, right? A Remington shotgun. A serious, serious piece of rifle that. Listen, if a 87 or anybody for that matter, catch you in a them sights and make one of them round there touch you, you already know it will not be a pretty sight. The doctors are going to have a hell of a time and remove metal out of your body. So after the shooting ended, right, them find two 87s suffering from wounds in a really bad state. But we're also hearing that one of them actually escaped. But you probably hear say sooner or later him turn up down at some hospital. But overall, this operation was a huge success, right? They removed one of the biggest contract killers in Jamaica, as you can see. 2020 was a very busy year for him, right? They removed one of the little apprentice 87 them who did their own him. Every single officer in SeaTac got to go home to their family safe and sound. And we also have one less rifle, a terrible rifle at that, taken off the streets. Excellent, excellent work from the police team. SeaTac, brilliant job. JCF, brilliant job. Right, we need to see more of this. We need to see more of this. Operations that are led by intelligence. Because this is the old style now work. That is why you could have a Scott or a Sci-Fi or a Hatties or a Bigger Crime who reign for so long and kill so much people. Because the style was, they must do something first, then you go and go lock them up. Nobody no come testify, so you have to let them go. Then go back out there, do the same thing, and it's never ending cycle. And 187, I wake up all 30, 40 bodies. So now, they must see anyone. Make we catch them in the act. Make them go for them gun. Make them put them gun in the car. Make them group up and I go pan them ops and then go for them. I love it. I'm loving it. So, as the book say, what is due to Caesar, give to Caesar, right? Excellent work all around. But don't be surprised in the coming days, you see them relatives and them kerosene start crawl out of the woodwork like some termite. Ready to tell you, say, how much treat them put on and how much free guineas them give back in the day, and the Remington where them catch him with a really bird him like a shoot, and there's a law-abiding youth and doing about nothing. So don't be surprised if you hear that happen, right? Or if you see it come to pass. But before the video done, I want to touch on something else. We're hearing about a story from Whitehall, and it just further proves that Jamaica is a rolling Netflix series. The story goes that some garbage collectors pick up the garbage, in other words, do them job, right? That's what they do, clean the streets, beautify the streets, right? Remove certain things so as people can breathe fresh air. The man then pick up some garbage. In the garbage was a weapon. So obviously, because they now go through every single piece of garbage for 2 and 9, and just throw it in a truck gone and mash it up. Here the sevens them get vexed. Here the sevens them now start to pre the garbage man them. How is this real life? How is Jamaica a real place? So now we're hearing that the garbage man them, right? The man them who should be focused on doing their job, right, which is, as we say, cleaning and beautifying the streets. Very important job, by the way. It's hard enough that they have to deal with the stench and the conditions and all these things, because I imagine it can't be easy working on a garbage truck and having to deal with some of them thing. But on top of that, they have to know I watch them head back from 87s, because 87s say anyway them catch them, they're going to do this and do that because of them take them machine. How many people realize say Jamaica is not a normal place? How much society you know that the garbage man them need police escort to them job? Police have here driving back at the man them? How long can that continue? That's not sustainable. You can't have police with them right through. Not forever, until thy kingdom come. So what gonna happen? Because it'll get to a point where if the man them realize that them genuinely under some kind of threat and the police, you know, so we can't escort them no more, the man them stop taking up garbage and they would have all right to. They would have all right to it. And besides, you know what? Well, stop taking up garbage, run a white hall. If the man them say, you know what, we not going to go work, they would have all right to. Because we don't know who go through them life. For the sake of saying, no, we must risk life and limb to go pick up garbage on a white hall. No. No. No, Sanky can't think so. This is madness. Police escort take up garbage. What kind of country we really have? Jamaica is a place where you have schools that are getting renovated. And 87s make the project have to stop. 87s make demand and no contractor no one come. No mason man no one come. No electrician no one come. Things have to stop. Pity them can't get them school renovated because 87s are dictated to people. Yeah, bitch, man, if you think twice, well, then figure out work. Because it means 87 say, they want to catch back, man, because a them take them strap, and they want back them strap. When a them go hide strap in the garbage, that ain't no sense. People, I'm going to tell you, sometimes I hear some things, and I have to scratch my head. If it never come in the Gleaner and the Observers and the Loops, we'll have to wonder if it's some kind of comedy sketch. Because this can't be real. Garbage man, they need escort to do them job. I don't know. I don't know who is going to risk life and limb, right? Because I don't imagine they're getting paid millions of dollars, right? So, from a cost-benefit perspective, if the man decides them not to work on a white house, them have all right to. Them have all right to because me no police can stay with them right through. Complete madness. Complete madness. And as me say, that is one of the job them, where if it's not done, nobody can live in peace, because it's an underrated career, right? Garbage collection, especially in Jamaica, people don't really respect them career, but it's a very important career in society. If them man decide to tomorrow, people always talk about police strike, teacher strike, fireman strike. Well, you see, if garbage man ever strike at Jamaica, I'm not gonna know who to serve. Anyway. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know. Vulture squad, stay circling, stay scavenging. People, stay safe, bless.